ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له، واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا ايها الذين امنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن الا وانتم مسلمون. يا ايها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحده وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والارحام ان الله كان عليكم رقيبا. ثم اما بعد، my dears beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, preparing for today's khutbah, I thought to bring something which is very easy to be digested, very easy to refresh our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to invest in this life. I choose a topic which is something to do with the number of three. Three is a number which is one of those winter numbers, be number one or number three or five and so on and so forth. So there are three stop stations today. Today is a Friday, we will talk about. And I hope those three stop stations will be our take home message out of today. The first stop, again, it consists of three things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran al-Kareem, in a very beautiful ayah, there are three kind of people Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves them the most. And they've been summarized in a very nice, beautiful ayah in the Quran al-Kareem. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء والكاظمين الغيظ والعافين عن الناس والله يحب المحسنين. Those three kinds of people Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves them the most. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in this ayah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء, those people who give charity, those people who help others during as-sarra wa barra. Sarra and barra means while you are in your peaceful mind and you have no crisis, as well as the other condition that when you are sick or when you are in difficulties and with so many calamities. Those type of people, you think about them yourself. Are you among those people? Do you want to hold this title which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves them the most? It's your decision and it's your thing, you have to think about it. الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ. This is number one. Those people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves them the most. The second kind of people, وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْرِ. Who are those people? Sometimes we are having a temper, we become angry, sometimes for something which is really doesn't need that blood pressure or that temper to go off. And those type of people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us that they will be the most loved by him. Each and every single individual, we came across so many anger time, either at home or at work, or even nowadays with the temperature of 50s or 60s, while we are in the car, we don't lose our temper. But mind you, my dear brother and sister, remember that your anger should be controlled. If you look around, in the Western countries, they are always going around that anger and how to control yourself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us how to control our anger. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, once upon a time, one of the Sahaba came to him and asked him, give me an advice. And he told him three times, la taghdab, la taghdab, la taghdab. So it's that message since 1400 years, and Unfortunately, we as Muslim people looking around to find out what are those steps which we have to take. And the recommendation is being given by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam 1400 years ago. La taghdab. Don't become angry. Don't lose your temper. As a matter of fact, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he used to become angry for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If anything goes wrong, if he found out munkar, people were telling and sahaba, we know that he is upset, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when we look to his face. So my dear brothers and sisters, this is the second type of people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loved the most. One of the other things comes in between a husband and his wife. Each and every single husband and wife, they have to tolerate each other. We have to do a lot of compromise to let this family to go on. Each and every single human being, he or she has their own faults. So we have to tolerate each other. And if you look at that right now, the statistics about the divorce rate goes up because the couples not anymore tolerate each other. Because he will be going into an anger fever because of something comes from his wife. It doesn't need all that effort for him to divorce her. So think 100 times, my dear brothers and sisters, about the rewards which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be able to give it to you. The third type of people, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. Those people who forgive. 100 times we came across somebody who always sometimes doing things against our will. So forgive him or forgive her for a little while. But again, forgiving, it shouldn't be lasting more than 2 or 3 times. Because if you sometimes forgive forever for the same mistake, he or she will repeat the same mistake and you need advice. As a matter of fact, forgiving, it doesn't mean that you just leave him alone. No. Forgiving by giving as well an advice. So in summary, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in this ayah, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظِ وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. And this is the end result about it, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those muhsineen. This is about the three people. Then the second three people which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't like them. And whatever you will do, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not give you any reward. Among those three people which Allah will not accept from them any good deeds is al-aql walidayn. Those people who don't listen and obey their parents' command. When I say parents' command, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everybody knows Noah's story with his son. His son, he didn't listen to his dad. Noah alayhi salam. And eventually what happened to his son? Everybody knows the story. What I'm trying to say, my dear brothers and sisters, take care of your parents. Take care of your mom and dad. Even if their orders goes against your will, with difficulty, you have to digest it. And by the way, nowadays, even sending a message by WhatsApp to your mom or your dad with a little bit of anger, in spite of all your good deeds, you're going to do it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept it from you. Because nowadays, the type and the way of disobeying our parents is totally different from 15 or 25 years ago. So take care of your parents. Even if they ordered you for something which is against your will, just follow their instruction. Please, my dear brothers and sisters. The second one, the second type of people which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept their good deeds, al-mannan. Al-mannan is the one who give and remind the one who received the giving from him. I gave you a year ago 100 KD. I gave you this food last Ramadan. I gave you this car. I lent you this and that. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept from those type of people al-mannan, his even his good deeds. The third one is that who sells his merchants or whatever goods you have and saying wallah and he is a liar. Don't ever try to sell anything, and if you from within yourself you are a liar, even if you don't do good deeds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept from you. So in summary, my dear brothers and sisters, from the first khutbah, we have three types of people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves them the most, and there are another three kinds of people which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept their good deeds whatsoever they are doing. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أجمعين. The third part of today's khutbah, another three things to remember. Everybody knows as-sabr, how to be patient. And as-sabr, it has three characteristics or three types. There is as-sabr ala ta'ah, that you have to be patient for worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And at-ta'ah, because to wake you up at 3:15 a.m. to attend Fajr prayers on time, jama'ah, it's a painful procedure. It's a painful act. But you have to be patient for it, because as-sabr ala ta'ah, you will be rewarded. This is the definition of as-sabr. You can teach your kids, you can teach the surrounding that the types of sabr are three. As-sabr ala ta'ah. All of us, 22 days ago, we were fasting 30 days in Ramadan for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's Jannah and heaven. And it is a painful act, and it's a painful practice, we are doing it. But for what? For the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As a matter of fact, how many of us, when we were waiting for to break our fast, and we don't even trust the TV, we have to hear Adhan. You were so much into doing a proper siyam. It's a painful practice. As-sabr ala ta'ah. The second one, as-sabr ala ma'asiyah. That you have to be patient away from ma'asiyah. Because sometimes, for example, listening to the music and songs, everybody knows is either haram, is or other scholars find out reasons to say why it is haram. You will be making a lot of sabr, a lot of patience not to hear al-ghina, music or songs, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So as-sabr and al-ma'asiyah. Smoking cigarettes, everybody knows. Drinks, alcohol, it's ma'asiyah. So as-sabr and al-ma'asiyah. So this is the second one, the type of as-sabr. The third one, which I'm going to conclude with, is that as-sabr ala aqdar Allah. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us and decided for us, a simple example is that beloved ones, we lost them, being a wife or a husband or a mom or a dad or our close friends or brothers or sisters. We have to be patient. So three types of as-sabr. As-sabr ala ta'ah, that we have to be patient in worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As-sabr ala ma'asiyah, that we have to be away and to be patient not to practice ma'asiyah and bad acts. And the third point, that we have to be patient and make a lot of sabr for whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us and our faith. اللهم اعز الاسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر اللهم اعداء الدين اللهم وانصر من نصر هذا الدين واخذل من خذل هذا الدين. اللهم اعز الاسلام والمسلمين واذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر اللهم اعداء الدين. اللهم انصر من نصر هذا الدين واخذل من خذل هذا الدين. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين.